Hello and welcome to another instructional video here at Reese's College for Alveo 7S Task 3. This is the task where you had to diagnose and rectify a turbo that was excessively noisy at speed, which you would have almost certainly completed on a vehicle on the ramp. You'll notice that I'm wearing my steel toe cap boots, and I've got my one piece overalls on to protect my skin, and my goggles, which are here to protect my eyes. I'm just going to tuck my ID badge in for safeguarding purposes and health and safety so it doesn't get tangled in amongst the vehicle I'm working on. And at the start of this, I'll put some barrier cream on my hands to protect my skin. So you can see here we've got diagnosed and rectified turbo excessively noisy. The first thing we're going to do is speak to the customer. And the customer has told me that whilst this vehicle has been driven under normal speeds, under normal conditions, that he's noticed a whine, a whistle, and a lot of a noise coming from the engine. Now, he's not sure where the noise is coming from. We're going to investigate this. We're going to diagnose and rectify it. So, once we've spoken to the customer, we might road test the vehicle ourselves and just see if there's any noticeable faults that we can hear. And the first thing we'll probably do is plug in the fault code reader and see if there's any faults on there. I'm just going to turn your attention over to the IMIE portfolio worksheet, which has got the registration number, approximate year, make and model of the vehicle. You'll need to populate this with block capital letters for registration number and 17 digits for the chassis number on there. Please try and put as much information as you can on here, and there is some technical data used to complete this, which you'll need from Autodata, which I've put on the board for you over here. Okay? So for this vehicle, we've plugged the fault code reader in, and it's coming up with a fault code related to the pressure charge system, okay? I've looked on Autodata, and these are the information it's given us. These are our wastegate operating pressure and our maximum boost pressure. In a minute, I'll show you some of the special tools that we're going to use. So I just want to bring your attention over to the vehicle, and the turbo is buried deep at the back of the engine on the exhaust manifold. So in order to inspect this vehicle, we first of all road test it and plugged in the fault code reader. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to inspect the intercooler and the turbo system. So you can see at the front, a large front mounted intercooler. We can test the boost parts visually for any damage. We can look at wiring for sensors, and we can start to remove the turbo off the back of here. When we're building it up, we're checking that all of these are tight and perhaps even clean out the front of the intercooler. So I've taken the turbo off the vehicle and I've got it over here so that I can show you, set up with a DTI gauge. Now what I'm looking at here is a wear on the cartridge, yeah, and I'm measuring the end floats in the cartridge. And you can see there that we've got some excessive amount of play on the DTI gauge. Now this would almost certainly indicate that we have got a blue smoke coming from the exhaust. The noise could be the turbine hitting the outer part of the turbo here. So this is almost certainly something that we would replace on the vehicle. And we would replace the complete unit, we wouldn't just replace part of it. So getting back over to my board, we've used the DTI gauge to measure the end float in the cartridge, and we're going to refit the turbo, the new turbo, or a reconditioned part, using fresh oil and a new return pipe and a new oil feed pipe. Once all that's done and we're happy that the vehicle is safe and ready, we're going to road test that, and we're going to take it out and just make sure that there's no faults with that. So remember, at the start of the lesson, we completed our risk assessment of the workshop. We did a bounce check on the ramp, and we would almost certainly scan the QR code on the two-post ramp. I hope this video has been some use to you. I hope that you find it useful, and I look forward to seeing your submission in my inbox. Thanks for watching.